Assalamu alaikum class. Yesterday we were having the discussion on the Bronsted concept of acid and base, and we have discussed that how the Bronsted concept of acid and base worked. Let me revise very quickly before we proceed towards our new concept or the new topic, that is the today's topic. Okay, students, I would like you people to switch on your videos. Yes, please switch on your videos. Bronsted concept of acid and base depends upon the donation of proton and the acceptance of proton. All those substances which are capable of donating proton, according to the Bronsted concept, they are considered as the Bronsted acids. On the other hand, all those substances which are capable of accepting the proton, they are considered as the Bronsted base. You have seen the several examples that we discussed yesterday. But students, let me tell you, this concept also could not flourish for a very long period of time, because this concept also has certain limitations. Because again, there came some substances in front of the chemists or the scientists who were not having the proton, but they were showing the acidic characteristic properties. So the time, it was a difficult time for the scientists to decide that whether they are considered to be acids or not. So in order to overcome this problem, the third concept came in front of us, and that is the most authentic concept, that is the most appropriate concept, which is still working, and we are following that concept of acid and base. We call it the Lewis concept of acid and base. Lewis concept of acid and base depends upon the donation of electron pair and the acceptance of electron pair. This is the third concept. It was proposed by Lewis, and it depends upon the donation of electron pair and the acceptance of electron pair. According to Lewis, all those substances which are accepting the electron pair from the other substance must be considered as Lewis acids. So Lewis acids are electron pair acceptors, whereas the Lewis bases are electron pair donors. Okay, let's start. Students, can you okay, can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, miss.
All right. Chemists, Lewis acids and bases. How did Lewis define an acid and a base? According to Gilbert Lewis, an acid accepts a pair of electrons and a base donates a pair of electrons. You must we keep on noting these definitions. According to Gilbert Lewis, an acid accepts a pair of electrons, means that is the electron pair acceptor, and a base donates a pair of electrons during a chemical reaction. Suppose, students, that there are two substances taking part in a chemical reaction, substance A and substance B. Now, to decide which of these two substances would be acid and which would be the base will depend upon, if we are following the Lewis concept, will depend upon the acceptance of electron pair and the donation of electron pair. Suppose that during a chemical reaction, substance A is accepting a pair of electrons from the substance B. So substance A is going to be considered as the Lewis acid. And because substance B is donating a pair of electron to substance A, so substance B is going to be considered as the Lewis base. Okay, so according to Lewis, an acid accepts a pair of electrons and a base donates a pair of electrons during a reaction. This definition is more general than those offered by Arrhenius or by Bronsted and Laurie. A Lewis acid is a substance that can accept a pair of electrons to form a covalent bond. Which bond? Not only the covalent bond, coordinate covalent bond, because when substance
coordinate covalent bond
exactly, because when the substance B, suppose we are talking about the two substances A and B, so if the substance B is donating a pair of electron to substance A, that is going to be shared mutually between the two substances, that is A and B. Donor will be one substance, but it is going to be shared between both of these substances. So when such type of sharing takes place, as a result of it or against it, a coordinate covalent bond is formed. So here also, when one substance is going to donate its electron pair or the lone pair to the other substance, it is going to be shared between both of the substances, and as a result of it, a coordinate covalent bond will be formed. A Lewis acid is a substance that can accept a pair of electrons to form a coordinate covalent bond. A Lewis base is a substance that can donate a pair of electrons to form a coordinate covalent bond. The Lewis definitions include all the Bronsted-Lowry acids and bases. We will see it in the other slide. How do they include the Bronsted concept as well as we will see that how does it include the Bronsted concept as well as the Arrhenius concept. Now, students, look at this example. Look at the equation, please. Okay. Please stop making this sound. Okay. Look at the equation that is given below. Be attentive. What is this, students? Come on, tell me. Where the cursor is moving. What is this?
Hydrogen ion.
Ion. Very good. Hydrogen ion. What does it mean? Hydrogen ion. What does it mean? Come on. Having how many electrons? No electrons? Yes.
No electrons.
Completely it is electron deficient. Okay.
It can also be called as proton.
We can also call it proton. Very good. Okay. Now, what is this?
These are representing the electrons in the valence shell of oxygen.
Very good. Is this the hydroxide ion or water? Yes, come on.
Hydroxide ion.
Actually, students, if you focus here, oxygen has two lone pair of electrons and it has two bonding electrons, but a minus charge on it shows that it has gained the electron from somewhere. Okay. Anyways, this oxygen, which has got this lone pair of electron, this oxygen is going to donate the lone pair to this hydrogen ion and is going to be shared between both of these ions. Hydrogen ion is also going to share this electron pair, and hydroxide ion will also keep this electron pair with it in order to complete its octet. Okay. Background se jo awaaz aa rahi hai, ask them to stop speaking. Okay. Now the oxygen, which has got the lone pair, oxygen will donate the lone pair, so it will become the Lewis base. And because hydrogen ion is going to accept this lone pair of electron in order to complete its duplet, so it is going to behave as Lewis acid.
After the donation and the exception, after the donation of electron pair by the hydroxide ion and the exception of electron pair by the hydrogen ion, a coordinate covalent bond will be formed between them, and as a result of it, water molecule will be formed. Is that clear to you all? Is that clear to you all? Have you got it? Students, have you got it? Students, can you listen me?
I'll listen you, listen you.
Yes. Students, can you listen me?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Stop speaking. Okay. Consider the reaction of hydrogen ion and the hydroxide ion. The hydroxide ion can bond to the hydrogen ion because it has an unshared pair of electrons, means ke lone pair of electrons are present on oxygen. Hydroxide ion is also a Lewis base, and hydrogen ion which accepts the pair of electron will be called as the Lewis acid. A second example of a reaction between a Lewis acid and a Lewis base is what happens when ammonia dissolves in the water. Okay, come on students, what is the formula of ammonia? Who will tell me the formula of ammonia?
NH3.
Very NH3. Good, very good. When ammonia is going to be dissolved in the water, what is the formula of water?
H2.
What is the formula of water?
H2.
Very good, very good. Hydrogen ions from the dissociation of water are the electron pair acceptor and the Lewis acid. Okay, when ammonia is going to be dissolved in the water, what will happen? Yes, who will tell me what is going to happen when ammonia is going to be dissolved in water? Yesterday you have seen the equation when we were discussing the Bronsted concept of acid and base. What happened when ammonia was dissolved in the water? Yes, according to ammonium ion was formed. Very good. How was ammonium ion formed? Very good. How was ammonium ion formed?
By coordinate covalent bonding.
Okay, fine. But what has happened? Where has the hydrogen come from to form the ammonium ion? Yes.
Miss, water ne ek hydrogen ammonium ion ko de diya tha.
Okay, fine. Kyun de diya tha? Who will tell me? Kyun de diya tha? Yes. If you look at the structure. Okay, come here, please. Look at the structure. What is the structure of ammonia? How many electrons are surrounded by ammonia in the outermost shell? Yes.
Two lone pairs.
No. Nitrogen has only one lone pair, dear. Nitrogen has total 5 electrons in the outermost shell. Out of these 5, 2 are in the form of a single lone pair, and the 3 are unpaired electrons which participate in the bond formation. Ammonia forms a bond with the 3 hydrogen atoms by sharing the 3 unpaired electrons with the 1 electron each of hydrogen. And as a result of it, ammonia is formed. But when we look at the structure of water, we come to know that water has got, yes, water has got 2 lone pairs. Oxygen has 2 lone pairs. And in water, there are 2 bonds formed between the oxygen and the 2 hydrogen atoms.
when ammonia is added in the water. Now, when ammonia is added in the water, what happens? That nitrogen being more electronegative than oxygen. Ammonia has got the nitrogen and water has got oxygen. Nitrogen is more electronegative than oxygen. So nitrogen, the lone pair of on nitrogen starts attracting the hydrogen present in the water and it starts attracting it, it starts pulling it. As the attraction grows stronger between the nitrogen and the hydrogen of water, the covalent bond which is present between the oxygen and hydrogen in water starts getting weak. And a time comes when the ammonia or nitrogen present in ammonia completely overcomes the force of attraction between the hydrogen and oxygen in the water. And at that time, the bond is broken down. Whose bond is broken down? The bond between the hydrogen and oxygen in the water is broken down by ammonia. And hydrogen ion in that way is set free. When the hydrogen ion is set free, it shows that it has no electron. And in order to become stable, it needs two electrons to complete the duplet. So the lone pair from nitrogen is donated to the hydrogen ion or the proton that was detached from the water. So nitrogen donates its lone pair to the proton that has come from water. And in this way, a coordinate covalent bond forms between them and it results in the formation of ammonium ion, NH4 with a positive charge on it, whereas the hydroxide ion is left behind. When hydrogen was leaving water in the form of hydrogen ion, hydrogen has lost its electron and that electron was gained by oxygen. And in this way, oxygen gained the electron of hydrogen and got the negative charge on it. Hydrogen ion was completely electron deficient and it was needing two electrons to complete its duplet. That deficiency was overcome by the nitrogen present in ammonia. It donated its lone pair to the proton that has come from water, and in this way hydrogen ion or proton completed its duplet, and as a result of it, the coordinate covalent bond was formed between them. Because proton has accepted the lone pair from ammonia, so that's why proton is going to behave here, or water is going to behave here as the Lewis acid, and ammonia is going to behave here as Lewis base because it is donating the electron pair to the proton present in water. I hope you have got it.
Yes.
Okay. Now, acid-base definitions, you already know. Arrhenius concept shows us that hydrogen ion should be produced in water if the substance is acid, and hydroxide ion should be produced in the water if the substance is base. Whereas the Bronsted-Lowry concept tells us that the substance should be considered as acid if it is donating a proton, and the substance which is accepting the proton should be considered as a base. The third concept that we are discussing is the Lewis concept, which explains that the electron pair acceptor should be considered as the acid and the electron pair donor should be considered as a base. This is the summary of the three concepts which you have learned. The Lewis definitions is the broadest. Why broadest? Because it extends to compounds that the Bronsted-Lowry theory does not classify as acids and bases. Actually, Lewis concept has completely overcome the limitations which were found after the proposition of the Arrhenius concept and the Bronsted-Lowry concept of acids and bases. There were certain limitations present in both of these concepts which were completely overcome by the Lewis concept. So this is considered to be the most broadest concept of acid and base. Okay, now what is this? Come on, who will tell me? What is this? Hurry up. What is this?
Ammonia.
Ammonia, very good. What is this? What is this? Come on, hurry up.
Bromine fluoride.
Bromine fluoride?
Boron. Yes. Boron trifluoride.
Excellent. Who was that? Excellent. Who was that?
Rabia.
Very good. This is not bromine, dear. Bromine. What is the symbol of bromine? What is the symbol of
Br. Br. Br.
But this is B. So it is boron. And it has got three fluorine atoms also. So we are going to call it boron trifluoride. Okay. If I ask you a question, students, you have to be very attentive, please. If I ask you a question that how many electrons is boron surrounded here? So what would be your answer? How many? When you are giving the answer, please think and then give the answer. Total how many electrons is boron surrounded by in BF3? Yes. Yes. Come on, hurry up. Yes, students?
Surrounded by three electrons.
Three electrons?
Three.
These are the three bonds which it has formed with fluorine, dear. Mass. F3 means three fluorine atoms. F3 means three fluorine atoms. And each fluorine atom has one bonding electron. So there are three fluorine atoms. It means three bonding electrons are coming from each fluorine. One bonding electron is coming from each fluorine. And it is forming a bond with boron. So naturally, if there are three bonds that the three fluorine atoms are forming, then boron should also have the three unpaired electrons so that it may form a bond, three single covalent bonds with the three fluorine atoms. So one bond is here, one bond is here, and the other bond is here. So in one bond, how many electrons are there? If there is one single covalent bond, how many electrons are there?
Two.
Very good. So if three bonds are formed by boron, so total how many electrons would be there?
Six, ma'am.
Six. Very good. Six electrons. So boron has three unpaired electrons, and boron is sharing the three unpaired electrons with the three fluorine atoms. And each fluorine atom has one unpaired electron. So three single covalent bonds are going to be formed here with one boron atom. Boron is going to share its three unpaired electrons, and each fluorine atom will share one electron to form the three single covalent bonds. So total boron is surrounded here by six electrons. Is the octet of boron complete, students, or is it incomplete? Is it complete or incomplete? Yes.
Incomplete.
Very good. The outermost shell or the octet of boron is incomplete. How many electrons more does it need? How many more electrons does it? Very good. Two electrons. Excellent. So where are those two electrons going to come from?
Nitrogen.
Very good. Nitrogen, which has got a lone pair on it. So nitrogen is going to donate its lone pair to boron. And in this way, boron will complete its octet. Okay. And as a result of it, a coordinate covalent bond is going to be formed between the ammonia and boron trifluoride. Between the nitrogen present in ammonia and the boron in boron trifluoride, a coordinate covalent bond is going to be formed. Now quickly tell me, among these two substances, who is going to behave as Lewis acid and which is going to behave as Lewis base? Yes.
NH3 is acid.
Lewis acid is the electron pair acceptor. Who is electron pair acceptor?
Miss Boron. Yeah. Boron.
Boron trifluoride will behave as Lewis.
Miss Boron.
And ammonia is going to behave as a Lewis base. Okay. All right.
No.
When a Lewis acid reacts, I don't want to please mute you all. You are very responsible students, to behave like responsible students. When a Lewis acid reacts with a Lewis base, the base donates a pair of electrons and the acid accepts the pair of electrons. Okay. Now you can see this equation. They have shown you here this electron pair from nitrogen, which is present in ammonia, is being donated to the boron, present in boron trifluoride, and as a result of it, a coordinate covalent bond has been formed. Okay, apply the concepts to this problem. Identify the reactant with the unshared pair of electrons and the reactant that can accept a pair of electrons. Ammonia has unshared pair of electrons to donate. Boron atom can accept the donated electrons. So, in this way, ammonia is going to behave as Bronsted Lewis base, and boron trifluoride will behave as acid. Okay, now Lewis bases donate a pair of electrons. So ammonia is the Lewis base, and Lewis acid accepts a pair of electrons. So boron trifluoride is the Lewis acid. Hydrogen ion donors also electron pair acceptors. Okay, hydrogen ion donors are electron pair acceptors. Is this statement correct, students? Hydrogen ion donors are electron pair acceptors.
Yes.
Okay. Very good. Ma'am. Because when they are going to donate the hydrogen ion will be completely electron deficient, and in this way, it is going to behave as the electron pair acceptor. Okay. Are hydrogen ion donors also electron pair acceptor? Yes. All substances defined as acids by the Bronsted-Lowry definition, an acid is a hydrogen ion donor, are also defined as acids by the Lewis definition, an acid is an electron pair acceptor. That means that these substances are both hydrogen ion donors and electron pair acceptors. Okay. So, according to the Bronsted concept, Bronsted has said that the proton donor will be acid. And according to Lewis concept, this concept has been completely, you can say, proved, because the proton donor will become the electron pair acceptor. So the substance which, according to the Bronsted concept, is the acid, is also the acid by the concept of Lewis. According to Arrhenius, acids are hydrogen-containing compounds that ionize to yield hydrogen ions in aqueous solution. Bases are the compounds that ionize to yield hydroxide ions in aqueous solution. According to Bronsted-Lowry theory, an acid is a hydrogen ion donor and a base is a hydrogen ion acceptor. According to Lewis, an acid accepts a pair of electrons and a base donates a pair of electrons. Hydronium ion, the positive ion formed when a water molecule gains a hydrogen ion. Conjugate acid, the particle formed when a base gains the hydrogen ion. Ammonium ion is the conjugate acid of the base ammonia. We have discussed this all yesterday. Conjugate base, the particle that remains when an acid has donated a hydrogen ion. Hydroxide ion is the conjugate base of the acid water. Okay, class. So, it is enough for today, and we are going to, inshallah,
start with the test by tomorrow.